Hey all, Tom here with a quick tip. If you've ever had a bunch of assets that you need to bring into Figma and you want to get them set up as components really quickly, here's a couple of workflows that'll really come in handy to do that. So let's just say we have a folder, and in this case, we have a whole bunch of SVGs that we want to bring into Figma. I'm just going to select them all and I'm going to drag them right onto the canvas. Figma will respect all of the original sizes of those SVGs and align them to a nice neat grid. Now, anytime you have a bunch of objects in Figma that are spaced equally, you should see these handles that you can use to just drag out and space these all nicely. You can adjust the size of the columns and the rows just by dragging those handles. Now, you'll also notice that each one of these also has a little grab handle, and you can hold Command on Mac or Control on Windows, and you can swap the position. So if you want to change the order of any of these, you just have to drag them around. Now, you might also find some stuff that you want to remove from this grid over time. So in this case, if we select one and then hold Shift, we can actually do a multi-select and we can delete them as well. Now Figma will reflow that row, but it's not going to make your grid into sort of like a nice even grid with wrapping from row to row. So in order to fix that, we can use a plugin called Quantizer. I can hit Command forward slash or Control forward slash on Windows, and we can actually search for the plugin which we have installed. And when we launch this plugin, what it will allow us to do is define how many columns we want to organize all of these icons into. And we can also control the spacing. So I'm going to go 10 columns, and I'm going to set the column and row gap to 16. And when we do that, it will nicely relay out all of those components the way that we want them. Now, the next thing that I want to do is I want to rename all of these. I'm going to be bringing in a couple different sets of icons, and I want to sort of earmark these as my 32 pixel sized icons by adding a suffix to each of the names. If we hit Command R or Control R on Windows, it'll bring up the batch rename dialog. This will happen anytime that you have multiple layers selected. If we press this button here, this will give us a little string that represents the current name of each layer, and then we can add our suffix to it. In this case, we're going to add underscore 32 pixel. When we hit rename, all of those icons will be renamed. Now the next thing that we have to do is turn them all to components. If we come up here to the component menu, you'll see that when we have multiple items selected, we get this new option here that says create multiple components. By selecting that, we now have turned all of those icons into their own individual main component. Now we can publish this for our team to start using. Now normally what you would do is go over to your assets panel, click on this little book icon to launch the team library modal, and we could hit publish. But often you want to access this modal pretty quickly because you want to publish updates to a library, or you want to accept the updates from another library. A quick way to get to this window without having to go to the assets panel is you can type in Option 3 on Mac or Alt 3 on Windows. This will immediately bring this modal up. Here we can hit publish, we can add a description if we want, and then once we hit the publishing button, in a few seconds, over 80 icons are going to be available for our team to start using. So hope this tip helps. Get up to speed when you're bringing in things like icons into Figma, and have a great day.